Have you noticed, whenever your parents want to visit a new place, what do they do first? Well, they enter the address of that place in Google Maps. And as soon as they enter the address of that place in Google Maps, Google gives them all the information about the place, about how to reach there, where it is located, and which are the nearest landmarks. So how do you think Google Maps does that? That you just enter some details about a place and you get all the important information, which road to take, which turn to take, all the important information? Well, that's because Google has some numbers stored inside it. So you see, for every house, there is a house number which is written on their door or near the door. And whenever the postman wants to deliver a letter, by that particular number, they are able to identify where to deliver which letter. Similarly, Google Maps has stored a lot of numbers for every place. So whenever you mark a place on Google Maps, what happens is it pulls out a unique number for that particular place. Now, what are these numbers? These are the latitudes and longitude. Now, what these latitudes and longitudes are? Well, these are a very unique number which are stored for every place on Earth. And because of these latitude and longitude, Google Maps is able to pull the right location of a place. So let's see what these latitudes and longitudes are. Now, before we understand the latitudes and longitudes, I will show you a very important thing. Now, this is our planet Earth. As you see here, there are no lines on planet Earth. In fact, even you see this line even here is not an actual line. This is an imaginary line. Now, why do we have this imaginary line? We have this line so that people can understand that the Earth rotates on an axis. And this is the imaginary axis which we have drawn. But this is not the only line which we have drawn. There are so many imaginary lines which we draw on planet Earth for our convenience. So let's see some of them. Now, the most important line here is the equator. Now, what equator does is that it divides the entire Earth into two equal halves. Similarly, there is another line, which is the prime meridian. Now, even the prime meridian divides the Earth into two equal halves. So what is the difference between both of them? Well, equator divides the Earth horizontally, while prime meridian divides the Earth vertically. So that is the difference between these two lines. But they both divide the Earth equally into two halves, which give us two important parts of Earth. Let's see what they are. So, the prime meridian divides the Earth vertically, isn't it? So, by dividing the Earth vertically, what it does is, it gives us the Western Hemisphere and Eastern Hemisphere. So, this is the Western Hemisphere. So, you see, this is the equator and this is the North Pole and South Pole. So, what are these North Pole and South Pole? Well, the northernmost point of our planet Earth is the North Pole, and the southernmost point is the South Pole. So these portions of Earth are called the poles, the North Pole and South Pole. And the division which was made by the prime meridian So the prime meridian divides it into two equal halves, eastern and western hemispheres. Now, what does the equator do? Well, the equator divides the Earth into two equal halves horizontally. So, which are the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. So this is the northern hemisphere here. So at the top of it is the North Pole. This is the southern hemisphere. And here is the south pole, which is here at the bottom. So you see, the equator divides the earth into two equal halves horizontally. Now, apart from these two important lines, there are some more lines which have been drawn on the entire earth. So by taking equator as the base, we have some lines drawn here, as you can see. So these lines, which are parallel to the equator, these lines are called latitudes. And how are they numbered? They are numbered with equator as 0. And then as you move towards the poles, the number keeps on increasing. So you have 30 degree, you have 60 degree, you have 90 degree here. Similarly, you have minus 30, minus 60, and minus 90 here. So in the northern hemisphere, the latitudes are growing like this, and they are 0, 30, 60, 90, and so on. Similarly, in the southern, we take negative numbers. So minus 30, minus 60, minus 90. So when you have any number that is in negative degrees, that means it is in the southern hemisphere. And if we have it in positive, then it is the northern hemisphere. Now, there is another way in which these numbers are written. So while in the northern hemisphere you have 0, 30, 60, 90, you can also write it as, in the northern hemisphere, it will be 30 degree north. And for southern hemisphere, it will be 30 degree south. So you see, for every number of latitude on the southern hemisphere, you can write them as 30 degree south, 60 degree south, and so on. And for northern hemisphere, it will be 30 degree north or 60 degree north, and so on. So this is how we number the latitudes on our planet Earth. Now, another important factor is that all these lines are parallel to the equator. So they are also called parallels. So the latitudes are also called parallels. Now, another important line is the longitude. How are longitudes drawn? Well, this is the prime meridian. And taking the prime meridian as base at 0 degree, we have drawn a number of lines on the planet Earth. So they all start with the poles and end at the poles. So all these lines here are drawn like this, and these are the longitudes. Now they are also numbered very similar to latitudes, but they start from the prime meridian. So prime meridian being 0, on the eastern side, they are numbered 30, 60, 90, 120, 150, and 180 is the last one. And here it's 0, minus 30, minus 60, minus 90, minus 120, minus 150, and 180 again. So you see, on the eastern hemisphere, you have the degrees mentioned in positive numbers. And in the western, you have the degrees mentioned in negative numbers. So another way of writing these is that you can write these numbers as 60 degree east. And here you can write this as 60 degree west. So this is another way of writing these. And now, as all these lines are drawn with prime meridian as the base, so these are also called meridians. So you see, longitudes and meridians are drawn with prime meridian as the base. Now, we know what latitudes and longitudes are. Now, these latitudes and longitudes together make up a grid which covers the entire Earth's surface. And
every point on this grid is one location. So whenever you want to locate something or somebody, we actually find the location of that person or that thing on this grid. And the point where that particular thing or person is located, that is the location of that particular thing or person. So this grid defines location on the entire Earth surface.
So now we'll see how we can locate a particular place on planet Earth with the help of latitudes and longitudes. So let's see. We have here Tokyo and Sydney. Now Tokyo is a very famous city and its latitudes and longitudes are 35 degree north and 139 degree east. Similarly, Sydney has the latitude and longitudes of 34 degree south, 151 degree east. So now tell me, which one of them is latitude and which one of them is longitude? Well, you see, this is 35 degree north. Now, how are latitudes measured? They are measured as north of equator and south of equator, isn't it? So, this here is our latitude. And how are longitudes measured? They are measured east and west of the prime meridian. So, we have this as the longitude. Similarly, this is 34 degrees south, which is south of the equator, which is a latitude. And this is 151 degree east, which is east of the prime meridian, which is a longitude. So now that we know what longitudes and latitudes are, so let's locate them on planet Earth. So let's see. This is 35 degree north. So let's see the line for 35 degree north. This is the line for 35 degree north. Now, we have 139 degree east. So, let's see the longitude. Longitudes will be like this. And this is the 139 degree east longitude. So, this is the line. It goes like this. Now, our location is at 35 degree north and 139 degree east. So, the intersection point between this line and this line will be the location of our city. So, this line and this line are intersecting here. So this is our city, Tokyo. So you see, with the help of latitude and longitude, you were able to locate the location of Tokyo exactly here on planet Earth. Now similarly, let's locate Sydney. Now Sydney has a latitude of 34 degrees south and longitude of 151 degree east. So let's locate these lines on planet Earth. So let's see. You have 34 degrees south, which is this line. And what about 151 degree east? Well, it's this longitude. Now these two lines are meeting at this point, isn't it? So this intersection point of this latitude and this longitude is the location of this city, which is Sydney. So you see, with the help of latitudes and longitudes, you were able to locate two different cities in two different regions of Earth accurately. That is the magic of latitudes and longitudes. And that's why we have latitudes and longitudes all over the Earth. So similarly, Google Maps is also able to locate any location on planet Earth. So as soon as you mark a location on planet Earth, what it does is it finds its latitude and longitude. So you see this here, 37 degrees north, and here 122 degree west. So here is our latitude and here is our longitude. So with the help of these numbers, Google Maps is able to locate this place and tell us all about its directions and how to reach it. So you see, we have for our convenience drawn a number of lines on the entire Earth. Among them, the prime meridian and the equator are the most important ones. And with them as the base, we have drawn some other lines. For example, with equator as the base, we have all the different latitudes. And with prime meridian as the base, we have all the different longitudes. And with the help of all these latitudes and longitudes, we are able to locate any place on planet Earth. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all learning resources as per ICSE, CBSE, IB, Cambridge, or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures across maths, science, English, and social science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged, and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubts. That's not all. You also get amazing prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at deltastep.com, learning is not just fun and easy, it's rewarding too. So register for free now.